Designing products can be tedious for some store owners, but the right tools can make the process easier. We've teamed up with Creative Fabrica to see how you can improve your print-on-demand design process and speed with Studio. Creative Fabrica is an online tool that lets you create product designs using thousands of templates, images, backgrounds, and fonts. Hey everyone, this is our second video with Jonty from Creative Fabrica. Last time we talked about all of the benefits for you as an e-commerce seller of the platform, but this time it's going to be a little bit more of a deep dive in Creative Fabrica's Studio, which is an online tool that makes your design process easier and faster.
Thanks for having me again. My name is Jonty. I'm one of the designers and creatives in the creative team here at Creative Fabrica. I want to show you a bit more about Studio. It enables you to create designs from scratch, upload your own files, edit text, and even generate some of your own art using AI. I'm here on the landing page, which you'll find if you search for Creative Fabrica Studio. Now, there are three tools currently: the Studio, Vectorizer, and Transfer. Just a quick look at the homepage here. This is where you'll see some recent projects that you've been working on and some popular templates from this week. There are hundreds of templates that are preloaded into Studio, all different themes, different designs, different assets that you can find for different purposes. I want to start by creating a simple design. So I'm going to hit create new design, and it's going to give me some options. Now, because we're working with Printful and print on demand, at the bottom here you'll find some really easy to use and convenient presets. As you can see, there are plenty of options. Let's just go for the unisex staple t-shirt. I'm going to hit create new design, and it's going to take me into the design window. The first thing I like to do is just to give my design a name, and say you want to create something unique. You have an idea in mind. You can come to Spark AI over here and enter a really simple prompt, and the AI art generator within Studio is going to give you some images. Let's try watercolor lemons with leaves. So Spark is going to give you four options. If you're not a fan of any of them, you can go to the regenerate option and it's going to do another run of the images. I don't mind this one, so I'm going to double click it and add it to my image. Now we can scale it up. The interesting thing to note about these images that are generated via Spark AI is they are natively transparent PNGs, meaning all this white space does not need to be removed. So you can download this as a transparent image. It's going to print onto whatever color you want without a white background or a border. Now, there are some other tools that we can go into if you want to add some text to your image. You can add some text via the text field. You can change the font here. Change the color as you see fit. I like to use the color picker just to pick a color from the image. There's a bit of a relationship between the two. You can also create patterns with this. These four squares here are the repeat on background feature. Select the image and say you want to tile this picture of this image of lemons to create a pattern. You can quite easily just hit that, let it do its thing, and it's going to create a tiled pattern that's going to go on forever. Now, it does keep the original image as the source, so feel free to just either delete or hide that via the layers panel on the right hand side over here. I'm going to delete that because we don't need it. And if I just zoom out here via the zoom out option, you can see that it's given me a tile that's fitted to the canvas. I can select all of these and resize them if need be. Really cool for posters or patterns or cushion covers, whatever you want to do with it, really.
This would honestly work so well for all of our print products.
You can see how you can combine the different tools within Studio to create even more, I guess, complex designs with a couple of clicks. You saw how easy that was to do.
All right, then what other tools can we have? Because this is great, and the fact that it's transparent is great, but if I'm already coming in with an image that has a background, what do I do then?
So say you have a photo or an image and you want to remove the background, or you just want to isolate a certain part of it. Within Spark AI, there is actually a background remover as well. So if I open up the Spark AI tab here, this little magic wand guy over here, that's the background remover tool. So I can open that one up and it's going to give me a new window where it's going to say add file or drag and drop here. This is an image that I want to create a design with, but I just want the person. I don't want the background. So you can just hit open, drag that into the background remover. The AI is going to read the image. It's going to remove the background and isolate the subject in the image from the background. And there you can see it's given me just the guy in the middle, and there's a transparent background there. I now have two options. You can either download that directly, or you can go and save and place on canvas, and it's going to place that into the same canvas that we had just set up before. So I'm going to delete my lemons from before, and now that is a natively transparent image. So again, I can go and put some elements behind. Say I choose some, find some graphics, and I want to put some leaves behind him, for example. And maybe want to put this floral kind of jungly pattern behind him. An interesting thing to remember is there is the layers panel over here, so I can go and drop and rearrange the layers so I can create some depth and variation in the image. And just like that, we have a completely unique custom design.
Okay, so we've removed the background and we know that that works. Let's say I've been working on a design myself and I upload it and want to change something about it. So I put it into Studio and I want to transform it in any way. What are my options?
That's a good question. So what we can do is we can create a new design. Let's create one from the Printful presets. And let's do something for a poster. I'm just going to search poster and it's going to give me the two options for the enhanced matte paper poster. Now, say you've been working on some designs that you've collected from elsewhere. That could be from Creative Fabrica. It could be something that you've created. You can upload any file format to Studio via the uploads tab. It's super easy to do. All you need to do is open the uploads tab, go upload files, and then navigate to wherever your design files are saved. So for example, you could have these watercolor leaves that you want to create some designs with. And I'm going to add a few of them to the canvas, for example. And there it is. It's added a bunch of these designs to the uploads tab. I can now add them to the canvas by clicking each one, and we can rearrange these as many times as you like to really put together a custom style artwork that you want. You can come down here to the background option and you can either add some custom backgrounds if you want to that are uploaded into Studio. There's a whole range of different styles here. Or say you just want to change the color. You can change the color of the background via these color boxes over here, or you can select this box here and it's going to give you a color window where we can change to different colors. I might change it to like a slightly off green, that's a slightly sort of beigey yellow that's going to complement the colors of the leaves. And then let's say you want to add some text. So I can go add a text field via the text option here. And then Studio is preloaded with plenty of different fonts that you can choose from in different styles. There's a font that I love in the fonts option called Oi, which is down the bottom here. It's super graphic and super bold. We can then add that to the canvas, color pick it. Again, you can come to the elements tab as well if you wanted to add some graphics. Change the color of it via the toolbar at the top here, maybe something that's just a bit lighter. And then in the layers panel, I can drop that beneath my layers. There we have a cool kind of funky abstract poster design. I think you get the idea of how much variability and variety there is that you can create within Studio. And the only custom asset that we just uploaded there were a couple of PNGs, and we've completely transformed the way they look.
That genuinely looks awesome. And it reminds me of why I am not a designer, because even with all the tools, I would still need that library of assets to kind of support me in that, at least while I learn. But thank you so much for coming. I felt like this was like a personalized tutorial for me.
Just remember that Studio and Creative Fabrica are all bundled together under one subscription. The assets, the unlimited downloads, and unlimited Studio. Thanks so much for having me, and I hope to see you soon.
Thanks for the pro tips, Jonty. Now that you've seen these tools, let me know in the comments which ones you'll use to create new products. Thanks for sticking around until the end. Click the link here to start creating your next bestseller with Studio. See you in the next video.